All right, welcome back, guys. So we have recently solved this problem known as bride hunting, right? And so I thought that why not just solve another problem on graphs so that we can concrete up all the information, all the knowledge that we have gathered from the previous question. All right. So this is another graph question, but worry not. This is also a medium level of question, but we will be able to solve this question in only 3 steps. Okay. So stay focused and stay alert because if not, you will get lost in between. Okay. Moving on to the problem statement. Morocco is an island near Africa which is very prone to forest. Forest fire says that it destroys the complete forest, not a single tree is left. The island has been cursed by God, and the curse is that whenever a tree catches fire, it passes the fire to all its edges, adjacent trees. Okay, so it moves to all the 8 directions. Since just assume that there's a 2D matrix and you are at the center. Okay, and if the fire starts, the fire will move to all the 8 directions possible. What are those 8 directions? North, south, east, west. Northeast, northwest, southeast, and southwest, and it is given that the fire is spreading every minute. Okay, so at a single minute, the fire will grow to each of these directions. Okay, that is every tree is passing fire to its adjacent tree in that single minute. Suppose that the forest layout is as follows, where T denotes tree and W denotes water, and we know that water does not burn, right? We know that. So your task is to is that given the location of the first tree that catches fire, we know that from where the fire will start, determine how long would it take for the entire forest to be on fire. You may assume that the layout of the forest is such that the whole forest will catch the fire for sure. Great. And that there is a then there will be at least one tree in the forest which has maximum, I think the question is not completely available. Okay, that there is at least one tree in the forest which has which will take the maximum time. All right, which will take the maximum amount of time. Okay. All right. In input format, first n contains 2 integers, m and n separated, giving the size of the forest. Thank you. The next n contains 2 integers x and y space separated, giving the coordinates of the fire first tree. All right, from where this fire starts. Okay, and after that, the next m lines. After that, we'll have a 2D matrix with T and W filled. W means water, which can't burn, and T means tree, which will, just burn. Okay, output format: single integer indicating the number of minutes taken for the entire forest to catch fire. Great, and we have constraints which are pretty low. So this is a sample input. We have 3, 3, which means the forest is of 3 x 3, and the fire starts from 1 to 3, and their indexing starts from 1, right? So this is our layout: WTT, TWW, and WTT again. This explanation. In the second minute, tree at us. Okay, so basically, this is from where the fire starts. Okay, at the first minute, this tree will burn, right? And at the second minute, this tree will burn. Okay, because after 1 minute, the fire passes on to another tree. And at the third minute, this tree will burn because this tree can emit its flame to all the 8 directions possible. So it can emit to here and to here, and to here, and to here, and to all these values. Since water can't burn, we don't need to check them. And what about this tree? We only need to calculate the minimum amount of time. The first we need to check when the tree catches fire in the smallest time. All right. So since it already has fire, it already catched fire at the first minute, we don't need to replace the value of 1 with 2, right? Neither do we need to increment it. But what about this tree? It was initially marked as not burnt. Let's say it's NB, which means not burnt. So we'll check it is not burnt, right? So it will catch its fire, and in the process of catching fire, one more minute will take time. Will take 1 more minute, so it will become 3. And after that, similarly, it will reach to this place. It will become 4, and after that, it will reach to this place, and it will become 5. Okay. So basically, we have elapsed 5 minutes, and that is exactly our answer. So this is basically our answer, and we have another example: 6 into 6 grid and 1 into 6, right? And basically these are our trees. So the fire starts from here, and after that it reaches to this and this, and similarly to all of these, and the answer is 16. Okay, so right now I'll just create a logic, and for that I'll use this short matrix, and the reason is simple because I don't want to complicate it a lot. So how am I going to solve this? How to approach this? Very simple. Let's say that you create a matrix. Okay, you create a 2D matrix with the same size, and that matrix name is time, okay, which indicates how much time. Basically, what we are going to do is we'll calculate the time that each tree takes to burn. Okay, so that is what we're doing. We'll firstly calculate time for each tree in which it burns, right? And after that, I'll simply find the maximum time, and that will be my answer, right? Okay, so after that, I'll just find my max time. And that will be my answer. So this is the most complicated step, calculate time for each tree in which it burns. So how will I do that? We'll move on to the coding part later, but now I'll show you my implementation. I'll create a 2D matrix name as time, and it will have the same size. Okay, so it will be like this. It will be initialized with the value of 0, which means 0 seconds. Each tree right now takes 0 seconds to burn, which means nothing. 0 means nothing, not burnt, basically my NB. So we'll have this value 13. Right, our indexing basically 13 means this value. Okay, so we'll come here and we'll see that, you know, I just have another variable which will be named current time. Okay, so my current time will become it was initially one. So since this is my first tree, I'll just paste the copy of my current time here. It will become one. Okay, now I'll check all of its neighbor. I'll need to check a few things, right? What do I need to check? I need to, you know, when I'm moving to all of its neighbor, I need to check whether they are in the boundary or not, right? Whether they are tree or not, because we don't need water, right? Not water. And after that, I need to check one more thing, which most of you might not even consider, but that will give you incorrect answer. Okay, what is that? That is current time greater than already allocated time. What I mean by this is, I'll just tell you in a bit, just give me a second. Okay, so we are here now. I'll find my trees. Basically these two values are water, so I don't even need to check them. Okay, I'll come to this place, right? So this is my tree. I increase my current time by 1, and I'll just replace the value of this 0 with 2. Okay, 0 means it is not burnt, and if it's a tree, then we can just replace the value with current time plus 1, right? Because it takes 1 minute. And after that, I'll look for all of its neighbor. So this is not its neighbor, it will become 0. This is its neighbor, right? So it was initially 0, which means not burnt. I'll replace its value with current time plus 1, it will become 3, and current time will become 3, whatever. And after that, both of these are water, so I don't need to replace it. But this condition comes now in hand. Okay, what I meant by that is the fire will spread to this position also, right? Because it will move to all of its neighbor, right? So I'll check, is the current time, is my current time greater than the already allocated time? Is 2 greater than 1? If it is, then just return. Then return. Why am I returning? Because it is already burned. It has already been burned in the past. Why would you need to burn it again? There is no need, right? I am just checking that if it is burnt or not. And by the way, if it is already burnt, but let's just assume that it had a higher value. It had a value of 4. Okay, if it was burned in 4 minutes, by the way, I don't think that this is possible, but let's just say that if it burned in 4 seconds and our current time was 2 here, and it again catches fire, so we'll just replace it with 3, whichever one of them is the minimum value, right? But I don't think that is possible, so let's just keep this condition. If the time, because current time will always be higher than the already allocated time, we know that for a fact, because current time is always increasing one by one. Okay, but still we'll just put this condition in order to be safe. Okay, so all right, it will one, great. And after that, it will spread to all of its place. I will check, this is water, this is water, no need. We'll come to this place, current time plus 1, 4. Similarly this, 5. And after that, the most simple step, iterate through the whole of the graph, check whichever one of this maximum, the maximum one is 5, print 5. Great. Now what, one more thing that I need to say was, now how will you check all of these things, how will you calculate all of this time? Okay, so for this there are many conditions, right? There are many possible ways. Some say that there is DP, some say that there is that you can use just Q for a sort of like BFS or DFS. You can also do it with this, but I say use recursion. Why? I always say one thing, one more thing that just look at the constraints. Constraints tell you half of the problem. The constraints are very low. I can use recursion as much time as I want, right? So why do I need to hyper optimize my solution when I know that there is a simple way with which I can get my answer, right? The constraint is 20. I can easily use recursion. But if the constraint were like this, instead of 2, it was 2000 or even 200, then I would have not, you know, using the approach of recursion. But I can use recursion. Why? Because the constraints are very, very low. So I'll just take the easy way out and I'll start solving my code because I don't want to complicate my code, right? If your code is working, don't complicate it. Okay. And well, that is also saying that if your code is working, don't touch it. But let's move on. So let's now move on to my favorite part, that is coding part. Okay, forest fire. Now I'll just tell you the three steps in which will come up. First step, take input. Now second step, the most important step, calculate what? Calculate time of burning for all trees, right? And what will the third step? The third step will be print the maximum time. You actually get the most satisfaction in the third step because you are printing the answer. Okay, so print the max time. Now I'll take my inputs. So firstly, I have the grid, the size of the grid, right? So I'll just map them into int and they are delimited by space, which I remember. So I'll just split them. Done. After that, we have this value of from where the fire starts, right? So I'll have two values, initial row and initial column, IRIC, not IRCTC. Okay, so I'll map them again into int input dot split. Done. Okay, now I'll create a G, which means my graph. You can also make it forest, but I just went with G. So for I in range of, I'll just go to the number of columns. Okay, I'm creating a list of list. So for I in range of M, I'll just create a temporary list. And keep this in mind that you don't need to typecast it into int because the value that you will be getting is either T or W. T means tree and W means water, so it won't be int. It will be just, you know, a string value which is by default, and you will just take your input and again you will split them. Done. And just g dot append your what temp, the temporary list. Done. I think we are done with the yeah, we are done. Now moving on. So how did I solve my code? Let's look it back again. I just created a time matrix. I just created a time, basically what, a time graph, a time, just a time graph. Okay, so it was that value of this time graph will always be equal to what? It will be equal to zero, right? I'm creating a list of list of the same size which my graph was supposed to be. Okay, so for I in range of what, M, the value should be not zero, sorry. Okay, sorry, this done. And after that, for j in range of n, okay, so now I've met, I have my time matrix which is of the same size, of the same figure, of the same dimensions that my graph was, but it has the value initialized with zero. Done. Okay, now what? Now I'll create a function. Since I'm using recursion, I'll just create a function named as count time. Okay, and in that I'll pass from where my fire starts, that is IR minus 1, because the their indexing starts from 1, my indexing starts from 0. So I'll take care of it by just subtracting 1, because 1 minus 1 equals to 0. So IC minus 1, and after that I'll just pass what I'll pass 1, which means the time. This is basically my current time, right? The value, the variable that we had here, the current time. Okay, so this forest fire, this is really, really, you know, this can get a little bit messy if you don't take the right approach. And this is a previous year code question, so let's just keep that in mind and solve it. Okay, so now I'll just create my function because I'll be using recursion. Okay, all right, so I have my row, I have my column, and I have what? I have my cur time, which means current time. Okay, I'll just make my function. Give me a second. Okay, so we had a few conditions, right? For what was the these conditions? We had these, right? Hashtag not this. So we have these conditions. I'll just copy them and I'll just write them. since we have already written them, why not take the advantage? So the first thing that I need to check is the boundary conditions, right? So how do I check the boundary conditions? If the row that we are at, is it less than 0, or the row that I am at, is it greater than m minus 1? Because if the grid is 6 into 6, then I can't go to a 7th or to a minus 1th, right? And similarly, I'll just check for column, is it 0, or is it less than 0, or is it greater than my n minus 1, right? Because m and n denote the maximum row, basically the row and column size. Okay, so if this is the condition, then what do? I don't do anything, I'll just return my first condition, done. After that, I need to check one more thing. What is that? If the place that I am at, is it a row or a is it a basically a tree or a water? Okay, if it is a if it is water, then just return, don't do anything. Okay, so how do I check it? I'll just go to that particular place, row and column, and I'll just check if it is water. If it is water, don't do anything, return. Okay, now my third condition, I need to check if this my time matrix, you know, if the current position, if the current coordinates at which I am, has it already been marked or not. Okay, if it has been marked, then its value will not be equal to 0. Okay, and if its value is not equal to 0, which means if it has been previously been marked, then I need to check that if its current time, if its current time is basically if the time at which I am, if it is greater than or not, which means if that tree has previously been burned or not. I'll just write this condition, row and call. If it has been previously burnt in less amount of time, I don't do anything, I'll just return, right? So after that, since we have already checked all of our boundary conditions, now what do? I'll just mark my current, the current tree at which I am, I'll just mark it with current time, which means that this tree burns at this particular time, this my current time. Okay, now what will I do? I'll just basically go to all my directions, right? I'll just move to all the 8 possible directions. And how do I do that? Very simple. I'll call my function again, right? And I'll just change the value. Like, I'll make let's say row plus 1 and column. I'll just move to this direction and I'll increment my current time. My current time by 1. Right, which means the fire had spread to this this neighbor, and the time has been increased. And since there are 8 possible conditions, I'll call this function 8 time again. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, done. So row plus 1. Now I'll just need to mark all the possible directions. So row plus 1, row minus 1, and just give me a moment. Column plus 1, column minus 1, row plus 1, column plus 1, row plus 1, column minus 1. Row minus 1, column plus 1. Just keep this in mind that you are not repeating the direction again and again, because that will lead you to trouble. Okay, so with this, I have just iterated to all of my possible 8 directions while incrementing my current time. Okay, now we're done with the hard part. Okay, well, actually not that hard. Yeah, I hope you have gotten the logic why I did and what I did. Okay, so we are done with this, and now it's my favorite time, print the maximum time. Okay, so let's just say that our answer is minus 1, because the time can't be negative, the time is already 0. So I don't need to check any more condition, because they have already told us that the fire will spread to the complete forest, and there will be at least one forest which will have maximum amount of time. So I just need to now to find that maximum amount of time. Okay, so for I in range of m, I'm just iterating now my whole graph. For j in range of n, okay, if my answer is less than this, basically I'm just calculating the maximum, so my answer will become time of j, and then just print your answer. Easy, right? I think I'm done. Let me just cross check it again. I've taken my input, I've calculated time of all boundary trees, this is my function, row, column, current time, I've checked my boundary condition, I've checked my trees not water, I've checked this current time condition also, and after that I've just allocated my time, I've called my function again, and this is the calling of my function basically the first time, and after that I've printed the maximum tree. Done. The satisfaction that you get. Okay, now I just need to copy my output. Okay, so where was I? never ever mess with the test case. They can ruin a lot of things. Okay, so this was my test case, and I'll just now to copy it. Okay, fingers crossed, run the code. No error. Enter 5. Yes, done. What about our question? What about our second test case? This big one, right? So let's move on. Run our code again. Enter 16, and what was the answer supposed to be? 60. Yes. And if you want, I can, you know, just show you the time. You know that time matrix that we created for the first one, because that was the one we solved, right? So this, I need to print this time matrix. Okay, I'll just print it here. Print time. Actually, not here. No, it will just do the trick. Okay, now let's run our code. See, 0 to 1, the fire started from 1, it spread to the second in 2, and this 3, and this 4 in 5, and that is exactly what we created, right? So we just, you know, firstly we created an image of how we will approach this question, of how we'll solve this question. Now we saw the different number of options that we had to implement this approach, and after that we choose the one which was easy to us and which will give us our correct answer without giving us a time limit exceeded or memory limit exceeded. And after that we just went wild and we just coded our code, and it works. So this was our solution for forest fire. Was easy, not that much complicated, but now we know how to approach this question, right? So after this, you know, we have already solved bride hunting, and this after that we have solved this forest fire. Now you know how to solve a graph type question, and I hope if you don't, then you just revise your question. If you have any doubt, then please feel free to ask them in the comment section and answer them all. And if you liked it, then like, share, comment, subscribe, and thank you for watching this video. Thank you guys.